They are now ready to develop a spectral alignment algorithm, and we will capitalize on the observation that a modification corresponds to either block insertion or block deletion in the peptide vector. And therefore, maybe, just maybe, we can use the analogy with sequence alignment, where alignment corresponds to the minimum number of insertion, deletion, and substitutions of amino acids. So our goal is to figure out whether we can find similarities between peptide vector and spectral vector by finding a longest path in a properly constructed spectral alignment graph. The only question is how to construct this graph. Let's start. In the beginning, let's construct first a graph that I call southeast M, M plus delta, which consists of a grid with M plus 1 rows and M plus delta plus 1 columns. Edges in this graph will simply correspond to all edges going in the southeast direction. And given a peptide A1AN of mass M and its modified variant peptide mod A1 prime AN prime of mass M plus delta, we can construct paths formed by this peptide, peptide and peptide mod in the graph southeast M, M plus delta, and such path is shown in this graph. So this will this blue path corresponds to a modified peptide with these two modifications shown in blue here, and this red path corresponds to a peptide with these three modifications shown in red here. So far, I failed to explain how to construct a path between an unmodified peptide in green here and its modified version shown in blue here. Let me do this now. So this path will start at the node 0, 0, then move to the node with the coordinates equal to the masses of prefixes of length 1 of this peptide, then move to coordinate with corresponding to masses of prefixes of length 2, and finally move to the coordinates to the node with coordinates corresponding to the masses of entire unmodified and modified peptides. We will also distinguish between two types of edges in the resulting graph. The ones that are showed by dashed edges are non-diagonal edges, and these are edges corresponding to modifications. They are non-diagonal because modification has happened. And this is example of a diagonal edge. There is no modification, and the mass of amino acids in unmodified peptide and in modified peptide are the same. So we will consider different paths in the southeast M, M plus delta. And in fact, any peptide with this mass M plus delta will correspond to a path in the southeast graph. Moreover, we can substitute these paths by a spectral vector with this mass M plus delta, and therefore any possible interpretation of a spectral vector with this mass M plus delta will correspond to a path in this graph. Therefore, I will rename this southeast graph into the graph that is denoted southeast peptide spectrum. And moreover, I will remove all light rows from this graph because I don't need it. All paths corresponding to pair of unmodified and modified peptide traverse only dark rows in this graph. And therefore, all light rows can be safely removed. The resulting graph will be called PSM graph of peptide and spectrum, which is defined as the graph where weights of all nodes in column I are equal to the i's coordinate in the spectrum vector. And the rows in this graph, it's important to note, have indices not equal to 0.123, but equal to 0, mass of A1, mass of A1A2, and masses of prefixes of the unmodified peptide. And in this formulation, the score between modified peptide and spectrum is simply the weight of pass for the modified peptide. And therefore, we have reduced the spectral alignment problem to the following problem in the PSM graph. Given PSM graph of peptide and spectrum and an integer k, we want to find a maximum weight pass in this graph with at most k non-diagonal edges. Well, we already know how to search for maximum weight pass, but how would you search for a maximum weight pass with an additional constraint that it has at most k non-diagonal edges? To find an optimal pass in the PSM graph with an additional constraint on the number of non-diagonal edges k, we will construct a yet another graph, which is called the spectral alignment graph. This graph will have k plus 1 layer, and each layer will be identical to the PSM graph. Weights of nodes in the spectral alignment graph will be simply inherited from the nodes in the PSM graph. Now, this graph on the right side of the slide, spectral alignment graph, is currently disconnected. There are no edges connecting different layers of this graph. We will connect layers of this graph in the following way. Diagonal edges from the PSM graph will stay on the same layer. For example, the blue edge stays on the same layer in this case. But non-diagonal edges from the PSA graph will move to the next layer, like in the case of the non-diagonal red edge on the right of the slide. Now, for the case of the next pair of edges, the same rule applies. And finally, for every pass in the original PSM graph, we will have a pass in the spectral alignment graph going through multiply layers. And the spectral alignment problem is now reformulated as finding passes in the K-layer spectral alignment graph. And our goal is to find a maximum weight pass in this graph. Before you implement the spectral alignment challenge, let me clarify some implementation details for you. I will introduce the notion of the diff array. Diff array will simply represent differences in the indexes of consecutive rows in the PSM graph. For example, diff of 2 will be equal to 2 minus 0, which is 2. Diff of 5 will be equal to 5 minus 2, which is 3. And here are all the elements of the diff array presented. Now, to solve a longest pass problem in the spectral alignment graph, we will define the variable score I, j, t, which is the maximum weight of passes from 0, 0, 0, the source of this graph, to the node I, j, t. And node IJT has just one predecessor in the same layer, and we can compute the coordinate of this node using the diff array. And it has J predecessors in the previous layer, and we also can compute the coordinates of these nodes using the diff array. Score, therefore, of I, J, and T can be defined as amplitude in the spectral vector J plus maximum over all predecessors score of this predecessor. To be more precise, we will use the diff array to specify the exact element of this recurrence. And of course, maximum score of all peptide with at most k modifications is simply maximum value of score m plus delta t for all possible T represented by green nodes in this graph. After you learn about so many algorithms from computational proteomics, the time has come to address the challenge problem for this chapter. In the same paper where Zara presented T-Rex peptide, they also presented Mastodon peptides, and we want you to reanalyze them from the perspective of statistical significance. It actually has never been done. There is nothing surprising about finding collagen peptides in mastodons, because mastodons roamed the Earth just 10,000 years ago. They went extinct because of the climate change and overhunting by humans armed with stone weapons. So we want you to analyze the mastodon peptides reported in this paper and decide which of them are statistically significant. We want you to find other statistically significant mastodon peptide that this paper possibly missed. And we want you to find hemoglobin peptides, if you can, matching spectra from mastodons.